Hello everyone and welcome to PharmaRocks YouTube channel. In today's video, we will solve the Pharma Quiz part 10. And today's our topic is a tablet dosage form. So in today's quiz, we will solve the MCQs based on a tablet dosage form. So let's about the quiz. So let's check the instruction first. Welcome to PharmaRocks YouTube educational channel. In this video, we will solve the pharmacy related MCQs. MCQ, it means a multiple choice questions. Quiz rules are there. There are a total 10 MCQs. Each correct answer carries the 4 marks. Incorrect answer will lead to the reduction of marks and the negative marking is a -1. Time limit is a 15 minutes. You may pause the video for noting down the answer and resume the video for knowing the correct answer. Comment your score after completion of your test. How to do evaluate the marks? So here is the evaluation of the marks. If you get the marks between 30 to 40, then your preparation is excellent. If you get the marks between 20 to 30, then it is a good preparation. 10 to 20 marks average and need to improvement in your exam preparation. And 0 to 10 marks, it is a very poor and need to study more to qualify the exam. So let's start and evaluate yourself before the exam and must comment your score after completion of test. Subscribe our channel for such more educational videos related to the pharmacy profession. GPAT, NIPER, DI and pharmacist exam preparations videos are available on our channel, so you can subscribe the channel and check our video list. You will get the more than 100 videos on our YouTube channel based on our pharmacy competitive exams preparations. So let's start the quiz. Solve the questions carefully. We provide you answer after the 5 to 10 seconds. Okay, so here is the question number 1 for you. So what are diluents? Question 1 is a what are diluents. The options are, option A, it provides bulk and enable the accurate dosing of potent ingredients. Option B, binds the tablet ingredients together and giving form and mechanical strength. Option C, aid dispersion of the tablet in a gastrointestinal tract. And the option D is improve the flow of the powder during the tablet manufacturing by reducing the friction and adhesion between the particles. You may pause the video and note down your answer. Correct answer for this question is option A, provide a bulk and enable the accurate dosing of potent ingredients. So question 1 answer is A. So what are the diluents? So diluents are a bulk forming agent and they enable the accurate dosing of potent ingredient. They act as a bulk forming agent and also as a filler. सो हमने रिजेंट में ही टैबलेट चैप्टर पे चार वीडियोस जो है वो अपलोड कर चुके हैं ऑलरेडी. वही चार वीडियो में से हमने ये क्वेश्चंस जो है वो आपके लिए सेट किया है. ओके, सो लेट्स चेक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. एंटी केकिंग एजेंट इज ऑल्सो कॉल ऑप्शन ए डाइल्यूएंट्स, ऑप्शन बी बाइंडर, ऑप्शन सी ग्लाइडेंट्स एंड ऑप्शन डी डिसइंटीग्रेशन एजेंट. You may pause the video for note down the correct answer in your copy. The correct answer for this question is option C, glidants. So glidants are also called as a anti-caking agent. Let's go for next question number 3. Star RX 1500 is used as a option A diluents, option B binder, option C glidants and the option D is a disintegration agent. You may pause the video for note down the correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option A diluents. Star RX1500, it is a modified starch and used as a tablet diluents. Okay, used as a tablet diluents. And it is a modified starch. Let's check the next question number 4. Avicel PH101, brand name of, option A microcrystalline cellulose, option B spray dry lactose, option C ethyl cellulose, and the option D modified starch. Avicel PH101 brand name you have to find. You may pause the video for note down the correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option A, microcrystalline cellulose. MCC is also known as Avicel PH101. Here is the question number 5. Diluents used in a chewable tablet. Diluent used in chewable tablet. The options are option A, microcrystalline cellulose, option B, mannitol, option C, lactose, and option D, tabletose. You may pause the video for note down about the correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option B, mannitol. So mannitol is mainly used in a chewable tablet because of their good mouth feeling and palatability. So mannitol is the key ingredient in a chewable tablet. Pharmarox, the way of success. We provide you the study material for GPAT, NIPER, Drug Inspector and Government Pharmacist exams. You may call or WhatsApp us on 9016312020. Let's check the next question, number 6. Manozem 2080 is a brand name of option A, microcrystalline cellulose, option B, mannitol, option C, lactose, the option D, tabletose. You may pause the video for not down the correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option B, mannitol. So mannitol का जो ब्रांड नेम है वो है मेनोजेम 2080. ओके, मेनोजेम 2080 इज आल्सो इट इज़ ए फॉर्म ऑफ ए मेनिटॉल. लेट्स चेक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. व्हाट आर ग्लाइडेंट्स. द ऑप्शंस आर प्रोवाइड ए बल्क एंड इनेबल द एक्यूरेट डोजिंग ऑफ पोटेंट इंग्रेडिएंट्स. ऑप्शन बी बाइंड द टैबलेट इंग्रेडिएंट्स टुगेदर एंड गिविंग ए फॉर्म and mechanical strength. It aids the dispersion of tablet in the gastrointestinal tract. The option D, improve the flow of the powders during the tablet manufacturing by reducing the friction and adhesion between the particles. You may pause the video and note down your correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option D. It improves the flow of powders during the tablet manufacturing by reducing the friction and adhesion between the particles. Question number 8. This tablet ingredient aid dispersion of the tablet in gastrointestinal tract and releasing the active ingredients and increasing the surface area of for dissolution. The options are option A, diluent, option B, binder, option C, glidants, and option D is disintegrating agent. You may pause the video for note down the correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option D, disintegration agent. Okay, so option D, disintegrating agent are used to disintegrate the tablet in a GI tract and release the active ingredient and increase the surface area for dissolution purpose. Question number 9. Which one is true for DIPAC? Which one is true for DIPAC? Options are option A, it contains 90-93% sucrose and 7-10% invert sugar. Option B, it contains 90% sucrose and 3% modified dextrine. Option C, it contains 95% sucrose and 5% invert sugar with all amount of cornstarch and magnesium stearate. And option D, it contains the 97% sucrose and 3% modified dextrin. You may pause the video and note down your correct answer. The correct answer for this question is option B, it contains 90% sucrose and 3% modified dextrin. It contains 90% sucrose and 3% modified dextrin is a excipient called a DIPAC. It is a sugar-based diluent. Okay, DIPAC is a one kind of sugar-based diluent and used in a direct compression techniques. Question number 10. Which one is true for sugar tap? The options are, it contains 90-93% sucrose, 7-10% invert sugar. It contains 90% sucrose and 3% modified dextrin. It contains 95% sucrose and 5% invert sugar with small amount of cornstarch and magnesium stearate. And option D, it contains 97% sucrose and 3% modified dextrin. You may pause the video and note down your answer. The correct answer for this question is option A. It contains 90-93% sucrose and 7-10% invert sugar. So this is all about the pharma quiz part 10. You can also solve the part 1-9 in our video list. So subscribe the channel and good luck friends for your result and comment your score after completion of test. Like, share and subscribe our channel for more such educational videos and share with your friends so they can also get the benefit of our videos. PharmaRocks, the way of success. We provide the study material for GPAT, NIPER, DI and pharmacist exam. You may contact Mr. Amar Rawal and call or WhatsApp on 9016312020. You can also join our WhatsApp group by call or WhatsApp on 9016312020. All the best.